hydrocarbons. They are produced naturally. For example, marsh gas contains CH4, and by burning of petroleum benzene, that is C6H6, is the major constituent of petrol, and automobile exhaust. Benzene is a known carcinogenic agent causing leukemia, that is the blood cancer. It also causes irritation of eyes and mucous membrane. Another hydrocarbon is ethylene, which causes premature senescence and abscission in many plants, especially in orchids and cotton. Now you can see ethylene inducing yellowing of broccoli, which is used as a salad, and of course yellowing of the cabbage, you can see, is nothing but the effect of ethylene. Nitrogen oxides. Nitrogen oxides are responsible for forming photochemical smog. You know that photochemical smog suppresses the primary productivity of the plants. They also cause acid rain due to the formation of nitric acid. They produce lesion, necrosis, defoliation, dieback and death of many plants. They also cause eye irritation, dilation of arteries, injury of lungs, liver and kidneys. And now you can see the photochemical smog in the big cosmopolitan cities. Fluorides. Fluorides are emitted during refinement of aluminium and rock phosphates. It causes necrosis. You know, necrosis is the persistent infection leading to death and chlorosis of the leaf tips and leaf margins. In human, fluorides cause mottling of teeth, weak bones, boat-shaped posture, and knocking knees. You can see here the effect of fluorides on the teeth and, of course, the effect of fluorides on human beings. Smog. It is produced by the combination of smoke and fog, causing silvering, glazing, and necrosis in plants, allergies, and asthma, bronchitis in human. Smog is of two types. Classical or London smog or sulfurous smog. It occurs at low temperature and contains H2S, SO2, smoke and dust particles. And some of you might be knowing that classical London smog resulted in the death of 4,000 people. Photochemical smog or Los Angeles smog. It was first observed in the midday at Los Angeles in 1943. The cause of this smog was brought to be due to the combustion of petroleum in the automobiles. And as I told you, not only the human beings, but the photochemical smog adversely affects the primary productivity of the plants also. Now you can see the effect of photochemical smog. Photochemical smog occurs at high temperature. It is formed by the reaction of two air pollutants, nitrogen oxides, mainly NO2, and hydrocarbons, in the presence of ultraviolet radiation of sunlight to produce ozone and PAN, that is peroxyacetic nitrate. And you can see the PAN injury in the potato leaves. The leaf color has becoming light brown. And PAN is one of the biggest pollutant of plants. Nitrogen oxides plus hydrocarbon, ultraviolet radiation of sunlight causes the formation of PAN plus ozone. Breathing ozone affects the respiratory and nervous system, resulting in headache, respiratory distress, and exhaustion. The PAN also blocks Hill reaction, that is the light reaction of the photosynthesis. Acid rain, Robert Angus. The coal and the oil burned by power plants release SO2 in the air. Automobile exhaust puts NO2 in the air. So both SO2 and NO2 are converted into nitric acid and sulfuric acid, and they are the cause of the acid rain. And some people say that presence of Mathura refinery is the cause of acid rain in Agra, and that is adversely affecting the Taj of Agra. Ozone pollution. Acid rain is actually a mixture of sulfuric acid and nitric acid. That is, it has usually 60 to 70% sulfuric acid and 30 to 40% nitric acid. Gases like CO2, that is 60%, CH4 20%, chlorofluorocarbons 14%, NO4 are strong absorbers of long wavelength or infrared radiations emitted by the surface of the earth. And that is the cause of global warming or warming the earth's atmosphere. You can see greenhouse effect. In short, you call it as greenhouse effect. CO2 is the principal greenhouse gas responsible for warming of the earth. In the next 50 years' time, the temperature of the earth shall increase by 2 to 5 degrees. And of course, a rise of global temperature by 2 to 5 degrees may lead to melting of glaciers and polar ice caps. And that is going to become a big problem for all of the world, that is about the drinkable water. Flooding of low-lying coastal plains, possible submersion of islands. People, they say, that in the next 200 to 300 years, all the coastal cities of the world, because of increase in the level of the ocean, they will be submerged. There was a severe depletion of ozone, about 40 to 50% above the Antarctica region. The ozone layer depletion is caused by chlorine atoms, and you know that one atom of chlorine can destroy up to 10,000 molecules of ozone and oxygen will be formed. You can see the comparison where less ultraviolet radiations and where more ultraviolet radiations are reaching the earth, and more the ultraviolet radiation, the more will be the adverse effects on the human beings and other living organisms. And that we will be discussing just after it. Incidence of cataract, skin cancer, including melanoma, herpes, photo burning, deficient functioning of immune system would increase. Now you can see the skin cancer and the melanoma, and this is all because of the ultraviolet rays. Damage to nucleic acid will increase, resulting in higher number of mutations. Water pollution. The addition of some substances or factor which degrade the quality of water so that it either becomes health hazard or unfit for use. Polluted water may be turbid, foul smelling, unpleasant, and may contain a number of pathogens. Now you can see the polluted water, and you might be knowing that in most of the cities in India, the polluted waters are added in the rivers of the different cities, and that is the main problem of contaminating almost all the rivers